Hi friends, welcome back to Angular Hero to Superhero series. If you are a beginner trying to learn Angular, there is another series, Angular 0 to Hero, in which I have explained all the basic concepts. You can find the link in the description. In this Angular series, Hero to Superhero, I am focusing on advanced concepts. In this video, I am going to explain about using async pipe in Angular. Let's start. Pipes are one of the useful features in Angular. They are a simple way to transform values in an Angular template. There are some inbuilt pipes shipped with Angular, and we can also create our custom pipe based on our requirement. As part of the basic concept series, I have explained about pipes and how we can create custom pipes. I have provided the link of that video in the description. I am going to explain how we can use async pipe in Angular. To understand about async pipe, you should have an understanding about observables and promises. I have also explained about observables and promises in the advanced concept series, and you can find that link also in the description. What is the need for an async pipe? Async pipe subscribes to an observable or promise and returns the latest value it has emitted. When a new value is emitted, the async pipe marks the component to be checked for changes. When the component gets destroyed, the async pipe unsubscribes automatically to avoid potential memory leaks. To explain the use of async pipe, I have created this Angular application. Here I have two buttons. One button is to fetch a list of countries, and the other one is to get the status. Let me explain the code. In app component HTML, on clicking this button, I'm calling get countries function. And on clicking this button, I'm calling get status function. And I have two sections. In the first section, I'm using ngfor to display the countries. And in the second section, I'm using ngif to show a status online or offline. You can also see I'm using a section variable to show one of the two sections. And in the component, I have the countries array, which is empty, the status field, which is false, and the section variable, which is initialized to country. When user clicks the get countries button, I'm setting the section to country. And when user clicks the get status button, I'm changing it to status. That is how I dynamically change the section. Actually, to explain about the use of async pipe, I should have used a proper backend and an API to communicate to that backend. But here, I have created a data service to mock that functionality. In data service, you can see inside getCountries function, I'm returning an observable, which is having an array of countries. I'm actually using setTimeout to return it after 2 seconds. Similarly, in getStatus function, I'm returning a promise, which is just resolving a value true after 2 seconds. In most of the applications, we subscribe to this observable, get the result, and assign it to the array variable. Like that, here also, we can use the then function to get the value from the promise and assign it to the status variable. And so we can see these two functionalities are working. Here, you can see we need to manually subscribe to observable, or we need to manually resolve the promise using the then function. Instead of doing these, we can use async pipe to do all these activities in the template itself. Let me create an observable and promise. Now let me comment this code and get the observable and assigning it to this variable. Similarly, inside getStatus function, let me comment this and assign this promise to this variable. Now this will not work, because we haven't subscribed to the observable or resolved the promise yet. So in the HTML, instead of looping through the array, let me use the observable. Now also we can see this will not work. But I can use the async pipe here, like this. Now we can see the data. Also here, instead of the status variable, let me use the promise and use the async pipe, like this. So this is also working. This is how we can use the async pipe to process the observable and promise in the template itself. Hope you understood. Please like this video, subscribe and support me. I'll be back with another concept soon. Thank you. Bye.